Good morning, everyone. How are you all? I hope everyone is happy. God bless you and your family. In the previous section, we saw about the nervous system. The nervous system, it's a network of specialized cells called nerve cells or neurons that act as a communication link between various parts of the body. It has two major components, the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system is the primary control center. It consists of the brain and the spinal cord. Second one, the peripheral nervous system. The peripheral nervous system, it's a network of nerves that connect the rest of the body to the central nervous system. Second one, neuron. Neuron are the basic unit of the nervous system, including the brain and the spinal cord. The cell body is called cyton or soma. It has a fiber-like projection called tendrons or dendrites. The dendrites, which have many fine branches, help carry impulses to the cyton. Impulses means a sudden desire to do something without thinking about the result. Another long tube-like projection called the axon extends outward from the cyton and ends in many branches. The axon or some neuron have a covering or sheath made up of fatty white substance called myelin. Such a neuron called myelinated neuron. Neurons whose axon do not have a myelin sheath called unmyelinated neurons. Next one, synapse. Synapses also called neuronal junctions, the site of transmission of electrical nerve impulses between two nerve cells or between a neuron and a gland or muscle cells. A synaptic connection between a neuron and a muscle cell is called neuromuscular junction. Next one, sensory neuron and motor neuron. Sensory neuron, the neuron that carry impulses to the brain and the spinal cord from the rest of the body are called sensory neurons. Next one, motor neuron. Those that carry impulse from the brain and the spinal cord to the various muscles and organ of the body are called motor neurons. I welcome everyone back to my class. Have you ever watched a plane flying in and out of an airport? If you did, you know that airports are very busy place to make sure all of the aeroplane land and take off the way they are supposed to. Every airport has a central commanded center called air traffic control. Your body has its own command center called your central nervous system. So today we are going to discuss about central nervous system. Central nervous system, it's made up of your brain and spinal cord. Now move on, brain. When you are in elementary school, your brain is growing in size. By the time you become an adult, it will weigh about 3 pounds. It's not very impressive to look at. In fact, it looked like a pumpy gray blob. Your brain controls just about everything you do. It controls important things that you couldn't live without, like breathing and your heartbeat. It also does things that help you in school, like thinking about how to spell a word and figuring out the answer to a maths problem. Your brain also helps you remember things that happened in the past, like the fun you had playing in the swimming pool last summer. Next one, spinal cord. Your spinal cord looks like a tightly woven ponytail hanging off the back of your brain. In reality, it's a bundle of thread-like nerves. This bundle of nerves is about as thick as your thumb. Your brain sends messages through the spinal cord. The spinal cord has many smaller nerves branching off it. When your brain needs to communicate with your body parts, the message gets there are through these nerve branches. Now we are going to discuss about structure of human brain. The brain lies within the cranium, a set of bone commonly known as the skull. Cranium means the bone inside your head that protect the brain. It covered by the membranes called meninges and cushioned against shock by fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. This fluid is found between the meninges and inside the brain. It helps distribute nutrient and other chemical to the neuron of the brain and collect waste from them. Meninges. Meninges, three layer of membrane known as meninges. Meninges protect the brain and spinal cord. The delicate inner layer is the pia mater, and the middle layer in the arachnoid, a web-like structure filled with fluid that cushions the brain. The third outer layer is called dura mater. The human brain controls nearly every aspect of human body, ranging from physiological functions, and it functions by receiving and sending signals via neuron to different parts of the body. The human brain, an average and adult brain weight between 1.0 kg to 1.5 kg. It is mainly composed of neuron, the fundamental unit of the brain and nervous system. Recent estimates have suggested that the brain contains anywhere between 86 million to 100 billion neurons. The brain, along with the spinal cord, constitute the central nervous system. It is responsible for thought, interpretation, and origin of control for body movements. Now move on, parts of the human brain. The human brain is made up of different parts and compartments for each of the functions. Take a look at the different parts of the brain. The first one, forebrain. Second one, midbrain. Third one, hindbrain. Forebrain. It is the main thinking part of the brain and control the voluntary actions. Voluntary action means, voluntary action, it's a basically action which initiated by our own conscious. The brain sends impulses from its to the effector via the spinal cord to neuron and finally motor neurons. This action is under the control of will, thus it's known as voluntary actions. The forebrain process sensory information that is collected from the various sense organs such as ears, eyes, nose, tongue and skin. It is because of the presence of forebrain, humans are placed at the highest level in the animal chain. The forebrain consists of the cerebrum, thalamus and hypothalamus. Now we will discuss about cerebrum. The cerebrum is the largest part of the brain. It consists of the cerebral cortex and other subcortical structure. It is composed of two cerebral hemispheres that are joined together by heavy, dense band of fiber called the corpus callosum. The cerebrum is further divided into four sections or lobes. First one, frontal lobe. In second one, parietal lobe. Third one, occipital lobe. Fourth one, temporal lobe. Functions of the lobes. Frontal lobe. The frontal lobe lies just beneath our forehead and is associated with our brain's ability to reason, plan, speak, move, make facial expression, problem solve, controls, initiate and self-regulate behavior, pay attention, remember and control emotions. Second one, parietal lobe. The parietal lobe is located at the upper rear of our brain and control our complex behavior including sense such as vision, touch, body awareness and orientation. It play important role in integrating sensory information from various part of our body, knowledge of numbers and their relation and in the manipulation of objects. Third, occipital lobe. The occipital lobe located at the back of our brain and is associated with our visual processing such as visual recognizing, visual attention and visual precipitation of the body language such as the posters, expression and some things. The last one, temporal lobe. The temporal lobe is located near our ears and is associated with the processing our precipitation and recognition of auditory stimuli, including our ability to focus on one sound among many, like listening to one voice among many at a party. Spoken language, verbal memory, visual memory and language protection including fluency and word finding, general knowledge and autobiographical memories. Now move on. Functions of cerebrum. The cerebrum is responsible for thinking, intelligence, consciousness and memory. It also responsible for interpreting touch, hearing and vision. The second one, thalamus. The thalamus is a small structure located right above the brain stem, responsible for relaying sensory information from the sense organ. Sense organ including eye, ears, nose and tongue. It is also responsible for transmitting motor information from movement and coordination. thalamus is a found in the limbic system within the cerebrum. This limbic system is mainly responsible for the formation of new memories and storing past experience. Now move on. Hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is a small and essential part of the brain located precisely below the thalamus. It is considered the primary region of the brain as it is involved the following functions. The first one receives impulses. Second one regulates body temperature. The third one control the mood and emotions. Control the sense of the taste and smells. Synthesize the body essential hormones. Next one, coordinate the message from the autonomic nervous system. Next one, control, peristalsize the rate of heartbeat and blood pressure. Next one, midbrain. Midbrain, smallest and central part of the brain. The midbrain consists of tectum and tegmentum. Tectum. The tectum is a small portion of the brain, especially the dorsal part of the midbrain. It serves as a relay center of the sensory information from the ear to the cerebrum. It also controls the reflex movement of the head, eye and neck muscles. Tegmentum. Tegmentum is a region within the brain stem. It is a complex structure with various components which is mainly involved in body movement, sleep, attention and different necessary reflexes. Now we are going to discuss about cerebellum. The cerebellum is the second largest part of the brain. Cerebellum located in the posterior portion of the medulla and pons. The cerebellum and cerebrum are separated by cerebellar tentorium and transverse fissures. Cortex is the outer surface of the cerebellum and it's a parallel ridges called the folia. Apart from this, the cerebellum has the cerebellar pendulous cerebellar nuclei, anterior and posterior lobes. The cerebellum consists of two hemispheres, the outer gray cortex and the inner white medulla. It is mainly responsible for coordinating and maintaining the body balance during walking, running, riding, swimming and precision control of the voluntary movement. The main functions of the cerebellum including it is sense equilibrium. Sense of equilibrium means the sense of maintenance of a divergence from an upright position controlled by receptors in the vestibule of ear position sense. A variety of the muscular sense by which the position attitude of the body as parts perceived. The next one, coordinate eye movement. Predict the future positions of the body during the particular movement. Both the anterior and the posterior lobes are concerned with the skeletal movement. Cerebellum is also essential for making fine adjustment to motor actions. Motor actions means motor skills are movement and actions of the muscles. So already I told Cerebellum coordinates and maintaining the body balance and posture during walking, running, riding and swimming. Now move on. Medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata is a small structure present in the lowest region of the brain. It mainly controls the body autonomic functions such as heartbeat, breathing and digestion. It plays a primary role in connecting the spinal cord, pons and the cerebral cortex. Also, it helps us in maintaining our posture and controlling our reflexes. Pons. The pons is the primary structure of the brain stem present between the midbrain and medulla oblongata. It serves as a relay signals between the lower cerebellum, spinal cord, the midbrain, cerebrum and other higher part of the brain. The main functions of the pons include control sleep cycle. Second one, regulating the magnitude and frequency of the respiration. Third one, transfer information between the cerebellum and motor cortex. Pons, it's also involved in sensations such as the sense of taste, hearing and balance. Today I give 11 hard words. First one, cranium. Second one, meninges. Third one, cerebrospinal fluid. Fourth one, cerebrum. Fifth one, cerebellum. Sixth one, medulla oblongata. Seventh one, pons. Eighth one, hypothalamus. Ninth one, corpus callosum. Tenth one, tectum. And 11th one, tegmentum. Once again, cranium, meninges, cerebrospinal fluid, cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, pons, hypothalamus, corpus callosum, tectum and tegmentum. Today biology assignment, explain in brief, describe the structure and functions of human brain. Thank you.